variety show. Pat Quinone on the big band. How about that? Ladies and gentlemen, our next performer is a powerful comedian. He's an Emmy Award winner. Emmy Award winner on this show. He got an Emmy for his work on HBO's Inside the NFL. He's co-host of VH1 Classics, That Metal Show, and Beer Money. How about that? Ladies and gentlemen, the very funny and very talented. He's got a brand new CD out, Hellbent for Laughter. Please put your hands together. Give him a warm welcome. Don Jameson in the house. Don, baby.
Thank you very much. Good to be here, Asbury Park. You feeling good? I'm feeling good, too. I'm celebrating 4 years with my girlfriend this week. Yeah, if you believe me, you clap a lot harder if you saw her. My girlfriend's way out of my league. Sir, you know what I'm talking about, right? You know you're dating a chick who's way too hot for you when you take her out in public and people come up and go, is this guy bothering you? My girlfriend said to me the other night, Don, put your finger on the spot where you know it gets me excited. So I grabbed my wallet. It's lucky I have it on a chain now. I was getting intimate with my girlfriend a few weeks ago, and I hadn't trimmed my toenails in about 2 or 9 months. Yeah, when we got done, she was covered in sweat. She was all nicked up and bloody. It was like she had sex with Edward Scissorhands. Plus, all the upholstery in our car got ruined. You got it? Good. I'm so into hard rock and heavy metal, I told my girlfriend, if we ever get married, I want our wedding song to be AC/DC Highway to Hell. Yeah, you know what she told me? Our honeymoon song's gonna be AC/DC Shot Down in Flames. I said, oh yeah, our breakup song's gonna be Guns N' Roses. I used to love her, but I had to kill her. We got any Guns N' Roses fans here tonight? Guns N' Roses? One of the most hardcore bands that ever lived is Guns N' Roses, right? Because when they were recording their first album, Appetite for Destruction, they were so poor, they actually all lived together in a storage unit in Los Angeles. Pretty hardcore, right? That's why I wish they had that show Storage Wars on the air back then. Can you imagine that? I bid $1,300 for that unit. I got 2 groupies, 3 pounds of heroin, and Guns N' freaking Roses, man. You see a guy wheeling Slash behind him on one of those hand carts. Guy next to him's all pissed off because he bid twice as much for the other unit and he got Mumford & Sons. We got any military people in here tonight? Military people? Anybody? God bless you. Yeah, give it up for the military people. We just had Memorial Day here. I myself am a veteran as well. I was a sergeant in the KISS Army for many years. I think we were in the same battalion together. I love KISS, man. They finally got into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, right? After 15 years, finally KISS gets in. I thought mini KISS was gonna get in before the real KISS. And the same night, Gene Simmons got elected to the Hair Club for Men, so that was awesome too. Now, I love KISS, but should a band as old as KISS be writing songs about girls like Christine, 16? No, they should be writing about women their own age, like Gertrude, 73. I love the band Motley Crue. Motley Crue is one of the craziest rock bands ever, right? Yeah, and they just announced they're going on their first farewell tour. I'm not sure whether to see this farewell tour or the next one, but they said they're retiring, and every 45-year-old stripper in America shed a tear that day. I think it's time for Motley Crue to go, because when you go see them live in concert, sometimes that singer, Vince Neil, he'll sing 3 words to the song, then he'll take the mic stand, put it out to the crowd, you gotta sing the rest of the song. If he sings any less lyrics, they're gonna have to change the name of that band to Motley Karaoke. Now, as Joe mentioned, I do co-host a show on VH1 Classic called That Metal Show. I don't know if anybody here has seen it. All right. 6 of you, awesome. Thank you. Thanks to you 6. Just found out today that That Metal Show is the longest running show in VH1 history. So thank you very much. Yeah. Which is kind of like being the smartest one on Here Comes Honey Boo Boo. Or having the nicest beard on Duck Dynasty. Sounds nice, but it don't really mean much, right? People always ask, Don, who's your favorite guest on That Metal Show? I tell them, there's a guy on our show named Kirk Winstein. He's in a band called Crowbar. It's my mom's favorite band. It's Crowbar. He loves our show, That Metal Show, so much, he actually got our logo tattooed on his chest, for real. We filmed it and aired it on our show. That inspired me. I'm like, maybe I'll get my favorite show tattooed on my chest too, right? But then I started thinking, like, how am I going to explain to my girlfriend the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles logo on my chest? She's still pissed off about the Big Joe and Henry one on my left ass cheek, so. My girlfriend and I, we watch those, you know what we love watching on TV is those true crime shows. You ever see those murder mysteries on TV? The Discovery ID, right? Now, I know I'm watching too many of those because the other day I was looking out the window and I saw my neighbor loading a really heavy suitcase into the back of his car. I wasn't thinking he was going on vacation. I was thinking he's dumping a dead body right now. Two jugs of antifreeze. Yeah, your car ain't overheating. That's how you poison your wife to death. Yeah, and if I see you at Lowe's or Home Depot and you're buying a shovel and duct tape and a rope, you're not a handyman. You're a serial killer. We don't have any kids, me and my girlfriend. We love kids, but we just don't have them. We're both in our 40s, right? And, you know, we got kids. Who's got kids here by round of applause? Children in the house. You got kids, miss? Right? See, I think if I had kids, I'd be a good disciplinarian, you know? Like, who hits their kids here? Be honest if you hit your children. They're the youngest guy in here. All right. Somebody call Dyfus right now. No, that's good. I'm glad that you admit it, because most young parents, they don't discipline their kids, right? They see the medicines on TV. They assign the kids bad behavior to the medicine, right? They'll go, oh, well, my kid's got ADD. There was no ADD when we were kids. You were a freaking spaz, that's all. Right? ADD, ADHD, what's that? ADD and high def? I don't understand that one. Hey, you guys, have been a lot of fun. I'm Don Jamieson. Thank you so much.
Help out, please.